broadband computing brings to us. Security and privacy. As we think that the secure server has a data room. Only an authorized user, only a legitimate user can access the profile, can access the application. Increased compliance, improved compliance. Everything that the server, every application data at one place. Far easier to meet the compliance requirement. Managing. Managing compliance on the network is far, far easier than managing desktop on the network. Increased reliability. The mean time between failure of the Wi-Fi client is a lakh hour, 1 lakh hour. That is the best of the desktop. Gives you 20,000, 30,000. 3 times, 4 times, 5 times more reliable. That is the kind of reliability Wi-Fi brings to desktop infrastructure. Rapid deployment. All profiles need to be created as a server. Every virtual machine need to be made as a server. Any modification, any changes need to be made as a server. User can be added faster and any modification, any changes can be made available to all of them faster. Improve disaster recovery. It is far easier to replicate a data center to a disaster site. And in case if anything goes wrong with the end user devices, any natural calamity or any other unfortunate event, you lose your devices, but you don't lose any data, you don't lose application. All you need to do, put another device into our appendix. Big reduction in power, cooling, and noise. Thin client consumes section of a power or desktop. There is no moving part in thin client. They make absolute no noise while in operation. Cooling. Assume there are 200 desktop running in this room. The cooling requirement will be very high. If there are 200 thin clients running in this room, cooling requirements will be go down drastically. Save money for the organization. Need to access business applications from anywhere, anytime. Now, users, we want to go to their desktop to work. Technology is mature now. This desktop authorization is for every organization, for everyone to use. Any application, any content, any device, any user, and that will be any environment. It's for everyone to use. If your objective is to get green and you want to reduce the carbon footprint, you want to reduce the power consumption or energy usage, thin clients are your biggest friend. The service life of a thin client is double or triple than a desktop. Your refresh cycles are long. Thin clients consume very less material, so they reduce the carbon footprint. The power consumption of a thin client is a fraction of what structure consumes. A best of the desktop, smaller form factor desktop consumes 70-80 watts of the power. Normally desktops which are used in organization, they consume 200 watts, 250 watts of the power. Even if you replace one desktop with one Wi-Fi thin client, and that thin client is operational only for 8 hours a day, for 200 days in a year, you save about 1550 rupees per user. If there are 500 users in your organization, in a 1 year's time you save about 8 lakh rupees. The service life of Wi-Fi thin client is 8 years. In an 8 year time frame, you save about 600 lakh rupees per year. That if you are using them 8 hours a day for 200 days in a year. If you are using more, you are saving more. That if power rates are 5 rupees per kilowatt in this calculation. If rates are more, your savings are more. Your business requirement goes down. Your power backup for your computing infrastructure goes down. Your cooling requirement goes down. And on top of this, you also achieve or you also fulfill your personal responsibility of getting green. Every analysis across the world is saying and forecasting huge growth in cloud client computing, huge growth in thin client computing, and our own growth of 200% year over year. It is a witness of it. Why? We are inventor of the thin client. We invented thin client. We are 32-year-old company. That's the kind of experience we have in this market. This is our core business. We have a largest hardware portfolio, largest software portfolio for every need, for every budget. We know this business better than anybody else. We do this business better than anybody else. Let's see how. We have quite understand that every user in the organization is not same. There are different users, their roles are different, their responsibilities are different. So based on the user need, they need to be divided into the groups. People though who need to access few applications to do their work, they can be divided into one group, task worker, for example, call center executive, billing, account. Those who need to access few applications to do their work. Office worker, people who need to access multiple applications. They can be put into one group. Power worker, people, those who need to access resource hungry applications. Those who want powerful computing experience, they can be put into one group. And mobile worker, people, those who travel a lot for a business purpose, they can be put into one group. And once you make the group based on the user need, it becomes far easier for you to make their profile. What application they have to access, what the peripheral they have to use, and what the content need to be delivered to them. Once you are done with the step number one and step number two, it becomes far easier for you to decide what kind of a desktop virtualization option you need for your user. Publishing or presentation, virtual desktop infrastructure, cloud PC, web page. Let these options be detailed. Publishing or presentation, where user only needs to access few applications to do their work. Presentation is one of the more and widely used options. VDI, virtual desktop infrastructure. For example, VMD, one of the finest and tested technologies, where user need to access multiple applications or they need to be given a full-blown desktop. For those, VDI is a better option. Cloud. Users who want to have a powerful computing experience, those who need to access resource-hungry applications such as designing or development. For them, cloud PC. Closing software. We can stream the complete desktop operating system to a distressed mode. A cloud PC is the best protocol in both. Shared computing. Where there's one desktop needs to be shared among 8 and 12 users. Where applications are busy. Where the applications are few, for example, for task workers or school net. Shared computing, shared desktop computing is the best option. That's it. Where users only need to access the application, they can be published over web. User get connect and work on those applications. Once you have decided the best option or the mix of the options for your user, the most important thing for you is to choose the right kind of an endpoint device, to choose the right kind of a thin client. A thin client which can complement every option. A thin client which can help your user not to compromise on their computing experience. And that's what we do. That's what we are master of. We do this business better than anybody else. We have a larger hardware and software portfolio. Let's see how we can help in this position. Wise WSS. Wise Streaming Manager. It's a provisioning software for the users who want to have a resource on the application. Users who want to experience or those who need a powerful computer. Software development, marketing, engineering. For them, provisioning system is to complete desktop operating system to a distributed system. And those who do not have any hard disk and any other storage. And why operation? The local resources of the endpoint device is utilized so that they can reduce the server resource requirement. Wise VDA. It's a wise virtual desktop accelerator. Because users get connected to the server, users get connected to the data center through WAN, through LAN or internet. This software enhances the performance over WAN, reduce the network latency, enhance the user experience over WAN. Wise TCS. It's a software which enhances the user experience from a various application such as multimedia. It has multimedia acceleration, USB peripheral redirection, interacting USB peripheral. For example, webcam for video conferencing or scanner or syncing of your smartphone to your virtual profile. Or user those who want to use multiple monitors with a virtual plane. Or a short form kind of application where user want to make or take calls. Their dialer is at the server. Or flag redirection.